ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies and gents, we're gonna go back in the day just a little bit. This is Sammy Cooke. Now, if y'all don't know who Sammy Cooke is, y'all got problems. All right, ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies and gents, I shouldn't have to do this, but I'm gonna do this. Now, I want all of y'all to know, this is about the affidavits. Okay, now, since we talking about the affidavits, see how I'm hitting download right here? Nah, that ain't supposed to happen. I'm sorry. This is supposed to happen. See that second box? Okay, it says zero for me because I'm already logged in. Then you click on that box. This window ain't worrying about that window. Why? Let me show you. Nope, that ain't it yet. Gotta do it again. I guess I have to worry about that window. Nah, don't need Adobe. I already got it. Leave. Come on now. Sam says he's gonna always be your slave. This is the other four share site. This is the CJS site. I don't have the link. It's on some of the older videos, 2015. That link. Oh, come on, give me my affidavit now. Now, download that one. Close the pop-up box. See this box? Don't need that box. This is the box we're looking for. So I'm gonna click on that box. And I think if I see download file, I think it already did. There it is right there. See? Downloaded. First time, I don't know why. Second time, here we go. Not this document. This is a different document. So I want y'all to pay attention. I'm eating a banana. See, that's me eating a banana. Protein and potassium in Hawaii and Florida. You know what I'm saying? Banana. Ladies and gentlemen, the affidavit is simple. I mean, really, it is simple. Your name, all lowercase. Your first name last, your last name first. Then you put the address in care of, if you care to. This spot right here, get away, get away. This right here, see this right here? Ladies, gentlemen, gentlemen, ladies. Okay. Sorry. I received a text message and I was paying attention to that. So that's why I paused. This section right here is for the county recorder. Now, what you guys don't know, let me tell you what we did. We did something different. Something totally different. The easiest way to get there is this way. Gonna pause for a second while we locate the file. Sorry, I'm looking to show you our power of attorney, how we did it for people in court. And I'm going to tell you the reason why we're doing this in court cases. As soon as the, got to get rid of this one. This is a blank one. Oh no, I don't want to get rid of this one. I want to keep this one. Let's get rid of you. This is the one I want to get rid of. Don't save. Don't get away. Don't. No, don't save. There we go. Okay. See, this is not supposed to be here. I know I'm going to have to cancel. Uh-oh. It closed out everything. Yep. That's how things work. Closed out all my Microsoft Word. Got to start it over. It's Dragon Naturally Speaking. They've been having a problem communicating. Twisting the night away. Sorry. Let's open other doc. I'm going to pause you guys while I open this doc. I know where it is, but somebody else's information is on it. Don't want to share that with you. 1 second. Ladies and gentlemen, at least 2 songs have gone by. I knew where the document was that I was looking for, but I, like I said, I had to get rid of the names of the party to protect the innocent as well as the guilty. And this person is definitely guilty. Okay, this is what I wrote. Erase this section when done. See, colon? And conjunction means separation. Your address, your birth certificate information, the BD, the DBA. Remember that the font makes a difference. You're filing this in a court of record. After you get it filed, stamped, you will file it on a county record. The county has to file it because it's filed in the court. Okay, so you see how I made it a motion and a recording at the same time? Well, this is what we were doing with our cases, especially our notices of removal. This is the notice of removal that we sent in. Okay, now when we sent this in, all he had to do was fill in the information. Where's my yellow at? This one may not have the yellow, it just might have the sections. You see, where, let's see, this is not the one with the yellows. Oh, duh, y'all's is the one with the yellow. So, everybody swinging, dancing to the music, on the radio, having a party, ladies and gentlemen. See all these yellow areas? That's for you to put your personal information. Yes, you can add other information to this document because it is yours. I told you to make it your own. Okay? Ladies and gentlemen, at no time did I say,
oh, the information right here is unnecessary. You don't need to do any of this. What you can do is you can do whatever you want to here.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the so-called Jurat, and the box that's above it is from the California All-Purpose Jurat, which has been accepted by many states and county recorders. Why? Because it simply explains what it explains. We're not supposed to be repeating the same song, so they figured it out. Now, I come running back to you. Good job, Mr. Sammy. Ladies and gentlemen, the individual who filed this in the court case that I was just mentioning, he changed all of this section. He did not sign this line. He printed his name because they were listening to somebody smoking crack or something. He printed his name. I said, is that the way your name is on the ID? That's the way you sign your name? He said, no. I said, and the court knows that too. They sent the case back to the bankruptcy court on the 22nd. I just got his email about it 2 days ago. On the 22nd. He just texted me before I started this video, even though I was already starting this video. He just texted me that he just got a letter from the bankruptcy court. Hasn't even been 2 days since the court remanded it back to the bankruptcy court. And he's asking me, what do we do now? Ladies and gentlemen, I did my part. Honestly, I did my part. I did his paperwork the way it was supposed to be done. Got it removed to federal district court. Oh, that's right. This is the person who didn't tell me that he had signed an agreement to be out of the place on the... What was that? The 1st of October? That he never told me about that agreement? Or that the property was placed into a trust? And it stopped the sale? That they put a lien on the property? That lasted for a year? He did tell me about that in the... lease or the lien ended, the year ended, and so the banks came after him again. So everything they were doing worked. The only problem is he doesn't have a copy of the trust that he put the property into. Amazing. So he changes the wording, takes away the effect. But ladies and gentlemen, he not only takes away the wording, let me tell you what else he did. He filled in this section with information about his birth certificate. This is not the first time he's filed an affidavit. I was with him when he was doing jurats and affidavits. And I know he knows what he's doing. But he started adding a whole lot of junk to the document, taking away from its force and its power. He said, witness by... and before God. Ladies and gentlemen, this document has nothing to do with God. This is a commercial instrument. It has nothing to do with God. So this is what we added, ladies and gentlemen, so that you'll know. I do hereby acknowledge and accept the oath of office of all officers of the court. And the United States, in full accord. And it should be with satisfaction, but we ain't gonna be going all up into that. Now, I want you to pay attention. That's the first section we added. This has been up on the net for about a week and a half now. We added this section. You might as well just be prepared to copy. The owner... of the true and real name. Nope, that's not the section we added. Where's the section? Oh, right here. That's part of it. Okay, notice what it says here. Pay attention. I formally and forever stake a claim on the name as the owner of the true and real name. Stake your claim. Rob Ryder, genius. Although he may not have intended it this way, please understand that you must stake or state your claim. So it has to be a claim. So claim the name. Make a claim on the name. Somebody asked me today, do we have to do an adoption of the name? Why? Why go through that redundancy, unnecessary redundancy? Exactly. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, this video was only designed to let you guys know, to let you see that the power of attorney document has its own power and weight. And by removing huge sections, and we're not talking about the address stuff, the birth certificate stuff, the parents' residence and all that stuff, or the maiden name, or any of that. We're talking about the actual wording of the document, because you heard some so-called guru say on a video, you don't want to add this and you don't want to add that. You don't want to do this, you don't want to do that, because that gives them jurisdiction. Please. The document isn't perfect, but that gentleman's document was done. When the court had not responded after us placing that onto the record and the case had not been dismissed, I couldn't figure out what was wrong until I took a look at it. And when I looked at it, I saw all of the errors taken away from the effect of the document. The number one error, he didn't sign it. He got it notarized, but it doesn't have a signature on it. Imagine that. So it had no effect. He took it to the county recorder. They wanted to take, and they did take, the DBA section out. But those idiots didn't realize that he didn't sign it. And now he's up Bandini's Creek, or Bandini's Creek, excuse me. I was going to say Pandora, but Bandini is the word for fertilizer. It's a Los Angeles, California thing. But Mr. Bandini Creek now is asking for direction on what to do. See, what I didn't tell you all is that when I give him a suggestion and he paid me to do the paperwork, yes, I'm mad because he paid me to do the paperwork, but that was still my time. And then he didn't listen, and now he's in trouble, and now he wants me to come and play Captain Save-A-Hole! Sorry, from the Captain Caveman! I am not Captain Save-A-Hole. I do not volunteer. I do not acquiesce. I do not accept. I do not consent to be your Captain Save-A-Hole. But because I met this family, I met the mother, and I met the daughter, I feel more than compelled to give them a hand. There are several things I can do. You know, the court said you can't do a notice of removal from federal court, from state court to federal court. I'm sorry, let me correct that. Only from state court to federal court. You can't do a notice of removal from bankruptcy court to federal court. That's a lie. And now I got to go through my paperwork because that's what I do. I say papers, people. Documentation, documentation, documentation is everything. Maxine Waters taught me that. Okay? So I document everything. And I have boxes and boxes. I had a whole lot more before I left New Mexico. I literally burned three 55-gallon drums worth of paperwork. Because I couldn't take it with me. You can't take it with you! Yes, I can. How you gonna take that with you? Mentally. So, ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen and ladies. My heart hurts. Because you try to help people. And then they, by their actions, show you they don't give up. And don't want your help. Ain't that something? All right, ladies and gentlemen, 18 minutes, had a little bit of Sam Cooke, and we're going to say thank you very much and have a good day.